Hi, this is Jay Lee. Hope all is well. I just wanted to go over a few things that we saw over at our UFO sighting event on October 29th, 2017 over at Hollydale Park over in Southgate, Los Angeles. The response was excellent. I think probably about 30 people showed up. I have to admit, I was a little nervous because it was a little cloudy when I arrived, but I noticed that the fog was breaking up and heading toward the north. You know, I really recommend coming over to these UFO sighting events. Not only do you see UFOs, but you get to hang out with people who get it. So many people are brainwashed and will fight you tooth and nail to preserve their reality. Not at our events. Everybody gets it. We're usually there anywhere from 11 o'clock to about 4 or 5 o'clock. So for those who really want to see a UFO, this is the time to come. So with this video, I wanted to show you what really stood out to me. Of course, this first one was an orb, perfectly round and pearl-shaped. It was not oblong like a latex balloon. There was no tether, no tether tag, and no drip point. This one hung out for about 20 to 30 minutes. I was actually able to capture it with all three of my cameras, my V520, my P900, and my A6000. There was about 20 of us that eyewitnessed this. It wouldn't leave, so I called it the observational orb. Fausto Perez was there, Robert Bingham came by, and there's a whole bunch of new people that ended up coming to this event. There's almost like a perfect storm of activity for this type of stuff to show up. I would say that this one showed up about a mile away. So the big question is, why do they come? Why do they show up? Well, the short answer is that we call them. According to Robert Bingham, the man known as the Summoner, when you call for them, they come to your location. I would say that we had about 20 to 25 objects show up this day, which normally would not happen. For those who think that this is a normal occurrence, need to go downwind from us and see how many they get. Anyway, I believe that when they come to our location, they give us little hints that it's them. A lot of times, they won't show up as normal. What's normal? A single or a cluster of foil or latex balloons with tether tags and tethers floating in the wind. Balloons really aren't that complicated. I hope you agree with me. I think seeing balloons in the sky is a rarity. Seeing unusual characteristics with these balloons is highly improbable. They give us subtle clues, or what I call indications of imitation, that give them away. Kind of like artificial grass or a cell phone tower that looks like a tree. I think that they hide or camouflage themselves because if they're biological, to protect themselves from the faster and stronger predators, or if they're mechanical, as an observational tool that aliens use. So instead of overlooking what we might think of as obvious, we look for uncharacteristic, distinctive features that might be displayed. This might include morphology, color, texture, theme, time, and kinesiology, the study of movement. I'm hoping you guys are beginning to understand that UFOs may look different from what you expect. UFOs are simply unidentified flying objects. They don't necessarily have to look like flying saucers. Anyway, I hope you liked the video. Please join LA UFO channel on meetup.com and please join us for a UFO sighting event. I'll see you guys next time.